had to give the American people their voice back by building something called Truth Central. No more Dropbox. The drop boxes are just so bad. No more drop boxes. The elimination of Zuckerberg Dropbox. I call them the unlock boxes, you know? They call them lock boxes. I call them unlock boxes.
I call it a micro seizure. What is going on with you, man? And also, I gotta admit, like, we'll get to the truth central thing. John, you've got truth derangement or Trump derangement syndrome, which I do. I oppose anything that he opposes. So now I'm pro Drockbach. I want a Drockbach in every pot, actually, is what I want.
I love Drockbach. I'm waiting for a Drockbach sponsorship.
I know, exactly. I'd like 1 month free to Drockbach. He was experiencing some significant.
Do you know the song by the B-52s, Drockboxster? It's a great song.
I don't know. And so look, we know from the news last week that Joe Biden could be running again. And if he did and he got elected, he'd be 82. I just want you to bear in mind, these are potentially the two options. God. They are falling apart before our very eyes. They're gonna end up in a pine Drockbach. I'm worried.
But Truth Social phone users can download the app today and get their voices back. And it's open and ready to go and go out and use it and have fun with it. And non-iPhone users are coming very, very soon to make Truth Social a free speech alternative to big tech platforms. Our team is working around the clock and has recently enabled every single person on the wait list to join the platform. A lot of people are on the wait list. Now you can join as of last night, I think at 10 o'clock.
Truth Social has now been available for some time and the bad news keeps rolling in. So bad that we don't do individual stories on the terrible developments of this obviously doomed venture of Donald Trump. But we're gonna do a little roundup. So two key tech executives who helped launch the platform just quit. They're done. They can see where this thing is going. The company's chief of technology and its chief of product development, they just left. And the platform signups have dropped by 93%. That might be connected to it. If they think that it's gonna go down, they'd hardly want to be fired. So sinking ship, rats, all of that. By the way, it was released on the Apple Store on February 20th. Some users are still on a wait list. It's been forever. And by the way, they planned, more bad news, they planned to expand the app for Android users, but it doesn't look like that's gonna happen. So you got the executives leaving, the wait list, not hitting your deadlines for launching on new platforms. By the way, even people like Roger Stone are now claiming that they've been censored on Truth Social because he posted this. Trump also warns again, a growing threat of terrorism by radical Islam. Mix in the predicted the 9/11 attack. I don't know what any of that means, but apparently they put a warning on it. And so now Roger Stone, who's one of like the longest serving devotees of Donald Trump, claims that the app is censoring him.
What is your reaction to Elon Musk taking a 9% stake in one of your competitors, certainly Twitter?
Well, you know, I think it's very interesting because, you know, the goal that President Trump has what I have and our team here at Truth Social is to open the internet back up so that the American people can get their voice back. So it's clear that Twitter is kind of a ghost town. They desperately need Elon Musk to be there. So, you know, it's probably something that Elon wants to do. I think he probably believes in free speech like we do. But at the same time, you know, there's not very much activity over at Twitter right now, especially when you compare it to sites like ours, where we're just in our beginning stages as we continue to test and bring people on day by day. Our interactions are already beating Twitter. And so Elon's gonna have a lot of work to do there.
Okay, they're already better. Our results show that was not the case, actually. They're not beating Twitter. And oh God, the projection is so good, you don't even understand yet. Because not only did he say that they're beating them, he said that Twitter is a ghost story, and you don't yet know how much of a reveal that was on the nervousness he has about his job. Why did he use the term it's a ghost town? That's so specific. Because very recently on Business Insider, there was an article. I spent a week on Trump's new social media app, Truth Social. I felt like I was exploring a ghost town. That's by Rosie Bradbury. He's just revealing that he read the article and he knows that nobody's using his dumb service.